In the first part of this series about using frequency separation in DaVinci Resolve, we set up the basic node graph and did some simple smoothing of the underlying skin tone of the talent. Hi, my name is Paul Wittenberg, and in this tutorial, we will fix the deep wrinkles around the talent's eye without using cloning as we go deeper into frequency separation. As you can see, the wrinkles by the eye distort as he moves his face. This makes cloning virtually impossible. We need the fine details to move and distort exactly as before. We start the process the same way we worked with the cheek and nose in part 1. We make a selection in a node on the timeline of the graph. Because part 1 thoroughly covers making a selection, I have sped things up a bit as I make a Bezier power window. And soften it. Because the grade is getting pretty complicated by this point, we can speed up tracking by turning the grade off using Alt-D. Now we go to the detail line of the node graph and add some serial nodes. This one will be the null. Just as with the tone line, we need the empty null so that our edits all add together in the final result. Using Alt-L, we add a layer mixer. I like to keep the node graph neat to avoid any later confusion about how things are working. Name this node Blur, and this one Full Detail. We go to the layer mixer and set it to Subtract. We've eliminated all detail for now because we are subtracting the detail layer from itself. We'll connect the key output of the eye node to the key inputs of the blur and full detail nodes. Because Resolve's default is to create outside nodes when connecting outputs to inputs, we need to go to the key palette and reverse the key in both nodes. We now have all three nodes using the same selection. We can now begin separating the fine details, like the pores, from the coarser wrinkles. Remember, everything that remains the same is cancelled out. Only differences become visible. So the first things to be changed by raising the blur in this node, the smallest details, appear first. We can turn the eye node off and on to see how much we've reduced the wrinkles. There's still work to be done on the tone. First, let's reduce the mid-tone detail. The skin around the eye is still darker than it should be. Hovering the cursor over the master wheel, we can use our scroll wheel to raise the brightness until it matches the surrounding skin. In part 1 of this series, I separated the deeper wrinkles into the retained details. If I had separated the wrinkles into the tone instead, the dark of the wrinkle lines could not have been removed as cleanly. As we play the video, we see how nicely the skin matches the surrounding area. Cloning would not have been able to match the distortions of the skin as the talent moved his face. To keep the node graph easy to follow, we'll select these nodes, right-click on any one of them, and go down to the Create Compound node. Let's label it CN Eye Detail. I use CN to make it easier to identify compound nodes when they are not selected. Okay, let's have a look at all we've done. Before and after. Off again. And on. My name is Paul. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a like. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. For Star Challenge Media, thank you.